not okay. Nothing good will come out because you are already hating on them. Oh, those people are Muslim, I don't want to go evangelize. No! Evangelize doesn't mean you go scream Jesus, Jesus. No, you just be kind, man. You show kindness, you show gentleness, the fruit of the Holy Spirit comes out of you. You show patience. You show generosity. Whatever you have, you don't have to have money. You can have generosity. If people are moving, you give a hand. Give a hand. We need to stop the wrong believing. That is the spiritual baggage. You know, we're still pouring new wine into old wineskin. This is what we mean by spiritual baggage. You know, legalism, substituting ritual for encounter all the time. Oh, you got to only take communion only once every 3 months or something like that. No. Never in the Bible it says that. Never. We need to change our thinking. We need to repent. You know, some of us believe that we're too sinful, broken to be redeemed. You know, some people believe that. They believe that God's love, grace, and forgiveness is only offered to a few. Some people believe that. They believe, some people believe that they cannot change His world. Totally cannot change His world. Oh yeah, it's the way it is now. It's done. You know, you can't change it. This type of baggage, you know, is way down on a lot of Christians, actually. Way that down. Sometimes it comes out in our study at home, you know. They're wrong believing. They come from different churches. Sometimes they say, oh, what if I do this? Will I have less of this? I say, wait a minute. Whatever you do comes from the Lord. Does the Lord have less of it? No. You see? Wrong believing. It's a spiritual baggage. We need to discard it. We need to discard it. And this can only happen when we know we have been set free. You know that? That you have been set free of all these things. Paul says, do not conform to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. How simple is that? By just changing your thinking. You know, yes, you have this world to deal with, but you're not of this world. You're children of God. Please write that down on a piece of paper when you go home. I'm a child of God. Don't just, and then all, let your heart just meditate on that. I'm a child of God. That means my Father is in heaven. My physical father is just a surrogate father. I did not come from him, but I came through him. You know, parents in this room, your children came through you. They didn't come from you. Please, don't be so arrogant. They came through you. They came from the Father in heaven. Alright? Don't ever be arrogant like that. Many, many parents cannot even conceive. Don't take it for granted that God has given the breath into your children so that He has chosen you. When you have a kid, He has chosen you to be the parents to bring up His children. Do not put that to waste. Do not try to be smart and say, you know what? I do what I want. These are my kids. No, they are not your kids. They are children of God, man. Have reverence. Have fear of our Lord. They are Lord's children. He loves them. That's why He came to die on the cross 2,000 years ago. because of all of us, when we end up in heaven, you're going to be like brothers and sisters. Yeah, you meet your husband, he's your brother. Finish. Your earthly, you still hang on to those earthly things, man? No, come on. You're in the Bible says you'll be transformed. You are transformed into a new body. This body is finished. Go in the ground. From dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Don't carry this baggage. This is the biggest baggage, you know? This space suit. If you think you have a space suit, please renew your mind. You have a spirit in you that God loves. God loves you. Every one of your children, they have spirit. Care for them. Point them. Point their spirit to the Holy Spirit. Point them. All you need to do as parents is to point them to Jesus. Don't try to point them to you. Oh, do the way I do. Really? I mean, children are not stupid. They get to about, you know, teenage years. They're going to point me to you. You? The next word's going to come out of your mouth is going to say, you hypocrite. But if you point them to the Father in heaven, they cannot say the second word. The second word will be hallelujah. Hallelujah. I have a Father that's perfect. He loves me even though I'm broken. Earthly Father, you make the first mistake. Why did you do that? Right? Why did you do that? Couldn't you have done something better? Can you not think better? Hey, I just gave you three. They're all condemnation. There's no life in that. You need to speak life the way Jesus spoke life into people. Right? So three things today you need to learn. Physical baggage, get rid of it. Travel light. And then emotional baggage. If you have something, somebody offended you years ago, let it go. Isn't that a song? Let it go, let it go. Then let it go. You know, some people, I meet them, they go, oh man, that guy, he pissed me off. You know, that was 37 years ago, buddy. You still carrying that baggage around? That is sad. That's an emotional baggage. Satan loves you for that if you keep having unforgiveness in your heart. Because you know why? Because Jesus will say, who are you? Jesus is all about forgiveness. So if you have unforgiveness in your heart, are you starting to look like Jesus? No. No. When you have forgiveness, you start to look more and more like Jesus. Jesus is coming out. The Holy Spirit is manifesting. The fruit of the Holy Spirit will come out. Delights in that. He said, now, son, you got it. Now you're moving like me. You're moving freely. And you're speaking life. And you're operating in the spirit, not in the flesh of unforgiveness. That guy cheated you in some car transaction and you're still holding on to it. You already have three new cars and you're still holding on to the old Honda Civic from 1977. You're kidding me? Right? We all go through that. You're like, some people mess you up and then you're like, ah, that guy. I'm never going to forgive that guy. Really? What if Jesus did that? It's by His grace. That's why He says travel light. Nothing you do can change anything. It's by His grace that you accept it. You know how I know? You know when Jesus was hanging on the cross, And there were two other convicts beside him, one on the left, one on the right. And one was taunting him. One was saying, you're Simon Curtis. You can't even save yourself. And the other guy says, don't do that. He told the other guy, don't say nasty things to him. He said, will you remember me when you go? Jesus said to him, surely today you'll be in paradise with me. That convict, his whole entire life, he did bad things. But in that one moment of repentance, Jesus forgave him. Otherwise, how can he say, today you're going to paradise? It's by his grace. Amen. So I just want to leave that with you today and just hope that you're blessed by this word. And I want you to know that, you know, as we grow into a seasoned traveler, as a Christian, a mature Christian, we will discover that all we ever need is his word. Amen. You don't need all those emotional baggage. You don't need those physical baggage. You don't need those spiritual baggage. Spiritual baggage. What if I go to the temple and I do this and I do that? No. No. Jesus is Lord even over the temple. He has his foot on the temple, you know. Surely as I know, because he says, the earth is his footstool. You think those temples has anything on you? Nothing. King Kong ain't got nothing on you. Jesus' foot is on that, man. When you declare Jesus in Jesus' name, yesterday when I got to the woman, they didn't know what was going on. I just said to the woman, in Jesus' name, what is your name, devil? He says, my name is James. He has to confess. Because I know who I am. I'm the child. Most high God, and he loves me. And he's in me. And his foot is on this demon's head right now. Because the Bible says, God said to Eve, he says, your child that will come will have his foot on the serpent's head. Foot on the serpent's head, you know. That means if I have my foot on the serpent's head, serpent tries to be funny, I just have to step further. What will happen to you? If somebody has their foot on your head already, are you still trying to be funny? You'll increase a little pressure. Pain. Demon was screaming. Pain. Convulsing. Pain. Screaming. Scream for almost 20 minutes. And I said, you all have to get out. And then try to call in the heavenly places. Try to call. I said, nah. I seal the heavenly places by the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, I seal that you cannot call for help. I gag you in the name of Jesus. He couldn't do a thing. Why? It's not that I'm any more special than you guys. I just know who I am. You just have to know who you are in Christ. All power and authority is resting in you. His name is Jesus. Okay? So be blessed. Thank you. We'll call up the community.